Hey guys, how to stay positive. It's so easy to get beat down and to get negative, and you have to really work and focus on being positive. Here are my 12 tips on how to be positive. Number one, eat healthy and exercise. Right now, I am working out, and I do it partly because, you know, physical fitness is really important to a long life and doing the things that you want to be able to do, like go on vacations or travel or go hiking. And so when you're physically fit, you can do that. But also, I exercise because I want to be mentally fit. I want to stay positive. Now, can you be positive and be unhealthy and eat bad? Sure. I know some people who are out of shape and overweight, and they seem to be very positive. But you're going to have a greater chance of being able to be positive if you are eating healthy and working out. And for someone like me who is prone to get brain fog or get down and discouraged, working out and eating healthy is really a big thing for me. So that's why I'm in the gym today, getting in a little bit of cardio. Number two, don't pay attention to the haters. Leave them alone. People are all equal. People are all the same. And if somebody out there has a negative opinion of you, fine. What does it mean? Does it change the reality of who you are? No, it doesn't change a thing. So don't let the haters get to you. There's always gonna be people out there who are not gonna like what you're doing. They're gonna have an opinion of you that's negative, and you can dwell on that, but I assure you, there are just as many lovers of you as there are haters of you. Sometimes I can get 100 positive comments from a speech, and then the one negative comment I get is the one that I respond to. Don't focus on the haters. Focus on the 100 positive comments. Tip number three. Don't worry about what you can't control, which is kind of the same as number two. In other words, if somebody has a negative opinion of you and you sit down with them, what can you do to really control their thoughts? No matter how hard you try, it is still up to them to come to their own conclusions. So don't worry about what you can't control. Tip number four, focus on what you can control. In life, you can get so stressed out and so worked up over all the things that you have absolutely no control over. Why not take that exact same energy and focus on the things that you can control? Learning, growing, focus on the things you can control, and you will be much more positive than if you focus on things you can't control. Number five. Remind yourself of your successes. The human brain has a tendency to think about the negatives. You know, we'll think, oh my gosh, I didn't do this. I failed this. I'm not good at this. Oftentimes we have a tendency to it's so easy for our brain to go back and think about all our faults and all our flaws and where we're not measuring up. But we will overlook all the positive things that we've doing or all the positive things that we've done. It's almost harder. You almost have to force your brain to focus on the positive things you've done and your accomplishments instead of dwelling on the negative things. Here's an example. When I was training for the 2009 USA Memory Championship, my coach, TC Cummings, had me make a list of all the successes in my life. Going back to when I was 12 years old, I won the Spanish class award. I sold more newspapers than any other kid when I was 14 years old. And I just made this list of 100 good accomplishments and successes I've had in my life. And he had me read that paper every single day, every single morning, to remind myself, hey, you have a history of winning. You have a history of success. You can do the same thing. Get out a sheet of paper and write down all of your successes, or as many as you can think of, going back to when you were 12, 13 years old. Things like, did you win an award? Did you help somebody? Did you go above and beyond? Did you try to learn a new skill? Did you try to do something that was hard? Did you have a success? Did you close a sale? And then make a list of all the positive things that you've done and remind yourself of the positive things. Because if you don't do that, your brain has a tendency to dwell on the negative things. Step number 6, notice what you're thinking about right now. In other words, start taking inventory of your thoughts. As you're walking or driving and you start thinking about something, just get in the habit. Is what I'm thinking about right now positive or negative? You know, if it's something you can't control, if it's a negative thought, be conscious of that and realize you have the power of your thoughts to shift that and to think of something positive. Step number 7, tip number 7, don't gossip. Gossip is negative. Eleanor Roosevelt used to say, great minds discuss ideas, average minds discuss event, and small minds discuss people. In other words, small people, small minds will sit around and they'll gossip about people. It's the lowest level of conversation. The lowest level of conversation you could have is to sit around with your friends and talk about other people. The next level up in the conversation, a little more intellectual, is discuss the events of the day. It's good. Hey, what's going on over here? What do you think about the government? Or what do you think about this sporting event? Or what do you think about Elon Musk launching a rocket up into space? That's the next level of intellectual conversation. The highest level of intellectual conversation is, and positive, not just intellectual, but positive, is to discuss ideas. Brainstorm with your friends. Hey, how do you think we could solve this problem? How do you think we could accomplish this? What do you think about going on this trip one day and traveling here or learning this language? Small minds discuss people. Average minds discuss events. Great minds discuss ideas. To stay positive, don't gossip. If your friends are gossiping, just don't participate. And maybe even tell them, hey guys, let's, you know, that person's not here to defend themselves. Let's talk about something else. And switch the subject to an event or an idea. That's a great way to stay positive. Gossip only drags you down. Tip number 8, visualize a more positive outcome. Whenever I compete in a tournament, whether it be a memory tournament or the few times I've competed in jiu-jitsu tournaments, which is not much, but I will visualize the outcome that I want to have happen. I will see myself winning. I will visualize myself holding the trophy. I'll visualize myself completing that event exactly like I want to complete it. And I'll program my mind to see it that way. There's power in visualization. You are getting your mind trained to seeing you succeed in that endeavor, in that goal. One of the best things you can do is to visualize. So visualize the positive outcomes you want to have. Because if you don't, the natural thing is for your brain to visualize all the negative outcomes and all the things that can go wrong and all the bad things. And that's going to help you stay negative. You don't want that. Tip number 9. Take one step towards your goal today. What's your goal? To lose weight? Well, go for a walk or drink a couple glasses of water. Don't have that cookie today. Take one step towards your goal. Is your goal to make more sales in your business? Well, pick up the phone and make 10 cold calls or make one cold call. Take one step to your goal right now. Take one step, take one action right away. That one action will make it easier to make the next action. I remember when I used to be a telemarketer and I had to make 80 calls a day. I was so hesitant to make that first call. But after I made that first call, the next one became easier and easier and easier. Take the first step towards your goal today in an effort to become more positive. Tip number 10, do something productive. Do something productive today. Read a book, learn something, exercise, go for a walk, spend time with your family, make a sales call, do something positive, because if you don't, naturally you may do something negative of just laying around or eating too much or drinking too much, or do something positive today. Tip number 11, ask yourself questions in the morning and at lunch and throughout the day that are positive. questions like, what am I grateful for right now? Maybe every morning get up, sit in your chair, and just ask yourself, what am I grateful for right now? What can I do today to have some fun? What can I do today to show somebody I care about them? Develop a series of questions that you are in a habit of asking yourself. Maybe in the morning when you wake up and you're sitting in your chair, or you're driving to work, or eating lunch. Get a set time where you can ask those questions every day. Ask questions to stay positive. Tip number 12. Develop three words that define who you and who you want to be. And whenever you're getting negative and down, remind yourself of those three words or who you are. My three words, I'm creative, I'm strong, and I'm a risk taker. So I like to remind myself, hey, you're creative. You're gonna always come up with ideas. And one of my biggest fears is losing my creativity. So I remind myself, hey, you are creative. Number two, hey, you are strong. And I mean that I try to be physically strong by staying healthy, but mentally strong. I don't give up when it gets tough. And number three, I'm a risk taker. I believe that greatness can only be achieved through taking risks. So those are my three words. Those aren't your three words, but can be, but you come up with your own. Those are my three. And remind yourself of your three words, who you are, whenever you start getting down and discouraged. So those are my 12 tips on how to stay positive. Staying positive is so important. Working out is one of the things I do to try to stay positive. But it's so important, you have to work at it. You have to consciously say, I'm gonna try to be positive. I'm gonna do these things. It's work, but it's worth it. Living a negative life is no fun for anybody. If you got value from this video, please give me a like. Please comment below with how you stay positive or what your favorite tip was that I gave you. Please share this. We need to get as many subscribers as we can because we're always teaching great things. Thanks, guys. I'll see you on the next video.